Hello friends, I am Dr. Madhukar Jadhav. In previous lecture, we have studied the introductory part of theodolite. In that, we have studied different types of theodolite, then different parts of the theodolite. In this lecture, we are going to study regarding details of various parts of theodolite. In that, parts of theodolite, important definitions related to theodolite and different axes of the theodolite. So first important part of theodolite is leveling head. Leveling head consists of upper tri-batch and the lower tri-batch. Upper tri-batch had three arms. Each arm carries a leveling screw or foot screws for leveling the theodolite. Lower tri-batch has got a circular hole through which a plumb bob may be suspended for centering the theodolite. Three distinct functions of theodolite or leveling head are to support the main part of the instrument, to attach the theodolite to the tripod stand, and third one, to provide a means for leveling the theodolite. So in this sketch, this is the theodolite and this is called as leveling head. This part is called as leveling head. In this leveling head, there is two plates or tri-batch. This is called as upper tri-batch and this is called as lower tri-batch. In between these two, there are three foot screws, first one, second one, and the third one is to the other side. With the help of these three foot screw, we can level the instrument. At the same time, at the bottom tri-batch, there is a thread. With the help of that threads, the instrument can be properly fixed on the tripod stand. So this leveling head plays very important role as far as working of theodolite is concerned. Then next important part is lower plate, or it is also called as scale plate. Lower plate, which is attached to a outer spindle, carries a horizontal graduated circle which is graduated from 0 degree to 360 degree, and each degree is further divided into 10 minutes or 20 minutes. Scale plate can be clamped to any position by a clamping screw and a corresponding slow motion screw. When the lower plate is tightened, the lower plate is fixed to the upper tri-batch of the leveling head. The size of the theodolite is determined by the size of the diameter of this lower plate. So depending upon the size of the plate or size of the lower plate, we can say that the theodolite is of smaller size, theodolite is of medium size, and theodolite is of bigger size, depending upon the size of the lower plate. So here there is a lower plate, and this is called as lower plate tangent screw or lower plate slow motion screw, and to other side there is a lower plate clamping screw. So with the help of this screw, we can fix up the lower plate. Then next important part is upper plate or vernier plate. Upper plate is attached to a inner spindle axis. Two verniers are screwed to the upper plate. It carries an upper clamp screw and the tangent screw. On clamping the upper clamp and unclamping the lower clamp, the instrument may be rotated on its outer spindle without any relative motion between the two plates. On the other hand, if the lower clamp screw is tightened and the upper clamp screw is unclamped, the instrument may be rotated about its inner spindle or inner axis with a relative motion between the vernier and the graduated scale of the lower plate. This property is utilized for measuring the horizontal and vertical angles with the help of theodolite. So here there is upper plate, and in upper plate this is one vernier, vernier A, and to other side there is a vernier B. So this upper plate and the lower plate plays very important role in case of theodolite while taking the hurlings. Then next part is plate levels. Upper plates carries two plate levels placed at right angles to each other. One of the upper bubble is kept parallel to the trunnion axis, or it is also called as horizontal axis. Plate levels can be centered with the help of foot screws. Then fifth part is the telescope. Telescope is supported on the pivots of the trunnion axis, which affords its movement in the vertical plane. So plate level for this instrument, here there is a plate level. So with the help of this plate level, or we have to level the instrument with the help of this plate level by rotating these foot screws. Now here there is one plate level and another plate level is there at 90 degree to the main plate level, and with both of these we can see that whether the instrument is leveled or not. Then another instrument or another part of the theodolite is telescope. So this part of theodolite is called as telescope. So telescope is very much important for taking the readings, or we can say for bisecting the different objects. So this telescope consists of eyepiece to the one end and the objective glass to the other end. So these are the different important parts of the theodolite. Then next we are going to study the different definitions which are used in case of theodolite surveying. So first definition is centering. The setting of the theodolite exactly over a station mark by means of a plumb bob is known as centering. So in case of theodolite surveying, centering is very much important. On exact center we have to fix up the theodolite so that measured angle can be an accurate one. Then second important term is transiting or plunging the telescope. The method of turning the telescope about its horizontal axis in a vertical plane through 180 degree is termed as transiting the theodolite. In other words, transiting results in change in phase. So if we see, so this is the theodolite. When this theodolite is rotated about its horizontal axis in a vertical plane, then that is called as transiting of the theodolite. So for changing the face of the theodolite, the transiting plays very important role. Then face left observation and face right observation. Face left observation is that the vertical circle of the theodolite is on the left of the observer at the time of taking the reading, while face right observation means when the vertical circle of the instrument is on the right side of the observer when taking the reading. So again from the previous figure, so this is the theodolite and this is called as a vertical circle. So when this vertical circle is to the right of the observer, then that reading is called as face right observation, and when this vertical circle is to the left side of the observer, and then that reading is called as face left observation. Then next definition is changing phase. The operation of bringing the vertical circle from one side of the observer to the other side of the observer is known as changing the phase. So generally when we are taking the reading with a theodolite, we are taking the reading with both faces, that is face left reading and face right reading. Next definition is swinging the telescope. This indicates turning the telescope in a horizontal plane. It is called right swinging when the telescope is turned clockwise, and left swinging when the telescope is turned in anti-clockwise direction. That is, when the telescope is turned clockwise direction, then it is called as right swinging, and when it is turned anti-clockwise, then it is called as left swing. So again, from this figure we can see that, so this is the telescope. So when it is rotated like this, then it is right swing, and when it is rotated like this, then it is called as left swinging. So swinging is nothing but it is a process of turning the telescope in horizontal plane. Then next definition, line of collimation, or it is also called as line of sight. So this line of collimation is an imaginary line passing through the optical center of the objective glass and its continuation. Suppose this is the theodolite, this is the telescope of the theodolite. So the line passing through this center of the telescope is called as line of collimation or line of sight. So in this figure, this is called as line of sight for the theodolite. Then next definition is axis of telescope. The axis is an imaginary line passing through the optical center of the object glass and the optical center of the eyepiece. Now generally, line of sight and axis of telescope are one and the same when the telescope is in horizontal position. So see in this figure, so the line passing through the center of the eyepiece to the center of the object glass is called axis of the telescope. Then next definition is axis of the bubble tube. Axis of the bubble tube, it is an imaginary line tangential to the longitudinal curve of the bubble tube at its middle point. So again, from this figure, bubble tube is to the other side. When the line is like this, so that is called as axis of bubble tube. Next one, so different axis of the theodolite. So see, this is line of sight passing through the center. At the same time, this is also called as axis of the telescope. Now this is the vertical axis of the instrument. So vertical axis passes like this, vertical axis. Then next, again vertical axis we have seen, horizontal axis or trunnion axis, it is the axis of rotation of the telescope in the vertical plane. It is the axis about which telescope along with vertical circle rotates in a vertical plane. This horizontal axis is also known as trunnion axis of the instrument. So again, from the previous figure, horizontal axis, so the line passing like this is called as trunnion axis or the horizontal axis, and telescope is rotating about this horizontal axis or trunnion axis, and along with the telescope, this vertical circle also rotating like this. So horizontal axis or trunnion axis. Then in case of theodolite, two adjustment plays important role. First adjustment is called as temporary adjustment of the theodolite, at the same time permanent adjustment of the theodolite. In case of temporary adjustment, if setting of the theodolite over at a station, the time of taking any observation is called as temporary adjustment. The setting if the theodolite over a station at the time of taking any observations is called as temporary adjustment, or in other words, when we have to set instrument say at point A. So in that case, first of all we have to adjust the stand of the theodolite tripod stand, then we have to fix up the theodolite on tripod stand, and then we have to make the centering and leveling. So this process is called as temporary adjustment of theodolite. Then permanent adjustment, when the desired relationship between the fundamental lines of a theodolite is disturbed, then some procedures are adopted to establish these relationship. These adjustments are known as permanent adjustment of the theodolite. So this is regarding the various important parts of the theodolite, then various important definitions related to theodolite surveying and temporary adjustment and permanent adjustment. So this is all about this lecture. Thank you.